Okay, we are live. So, we're live.
Well, hello everyone. It's 5 o'clock, it's communion time. And I have Hans here with me, but we're just going to wait for a little while until a few of you have a chance to log in, and we'll have some communion together and share something from the Word. And so we'll just wait until the others have had an opportunity to get on. What do you reckon, Hansie?
Hello, everyone. It's just great to be here. It's always good to take communion together. So I've just been honored to be asked to come and take communion with some people online and with Royree. So yeah, looking forward to it. I love it. I love the grace that comes.
Yeah, now that they're relaxing the restrictions, you know, you can have your germy friends around. And at least a few of them.
Yeah.
And we can have this together, so it's good. And, you know, I'd just like to say to you that maybe you want to get your husband, your wife, one of your kids, or and gradually, as the weeks go by, maybe you could just have a communion group that would be able to share communion together, whether it's now or through the day, or, you know, at 5 o'clock or later on. It doesn't matter, but I'm hoping that the sound is okay. We've had a little bit of an issue with the sound again, but yeah. Trust it's all okay for everyone.
All right, you've got 10 people on.
So just let us know how the sound is. That'd be good to hear back from you.
Sure.
Sounds like we have people coming online, so hello to everyone from wherever you are in Australia or around the world, and always great to see people jump on and be with us.
Okay, so I think we should just start, and others might join us as we go along. Today it's communion again, and it's about the bread and the wine, representing the body and the blood of Jesus. And so normally we do it in a general sense, and we will today, but I had a burden this afternoon that I realized that there's going to be somebody watching this either as we do communion or who will look at it in the next 24, 48 hours, something like that. Someone who's feeling really, really down to the point where you're thinking about taking your own life. So I want to really let you know, whoever you are and wherever you are, that this communion today, of course it's for everyone, but it's specifically a word from God for you about the preciousness of who you are, and there's nothing that is out of reach of the blood of Jesus Christ. So just want to say that. Did you want to add anything?
I think communion is always about knowing that God absolutely wants to be with us as his creation. He made a way for himself to not just be with us, but to be united with us. So specifically for that person who is struggling, just know that God's, his whole purpose was to come to do this, to be with you in union. Know that you are absolutely loved and pursued, and that God wants this for you and wants you for himself as well.
So we're going to be, I wanted to just share a little bit from the Word and emphasize the power of the blood, the power of the blood. I think back to right at the beginning of time, when Adam and Eve in the garden, they sinned. You know, they ate the apple, banana, whatever it was. But they sinned, and they knew that they were guilty before God, and they were ashamed. And so they realized also that they were naked. Up until then, they'd been covered in glory, the glory of God. But now, because of their sin, the glory has departed. And they're conspicuously without cover. So what do? They go and get fig leaves. can you believe? And cover themselves with fig leaves or whatever leaves. And I'm like, wow, okay, what a thought. Here's the thing. When God knew that they had sinned and needed to be covered, he went near to the fig leaves. No, that's not going to cut it. I'm going to give them animal skins. So right from the very beginning, the animal had to be slain to get the skin to cover man's sin. So from the very earliest, man's sin was covered by blood. And right through the Old Testament, we read about the sacrifices that were made to cover man's sin. But then we get into the New Covenant, into the New Testament, and we find it's no longer the blood of animals, bulls, and goats, but now it's the precious blood of Jesus. And it is limitless in its power because it's the lifeblood of a living God, not the blood of animals, but the lifeblood of a living God, Jesus, man, God, who shed his blood for us. And that blood was going to be totally without limit.
Yeah, again, just speaks so powerfully of the fact that God never left us. Adam didn't leave Eden without a covering, without a provision from God, and then that ultimately manifested in a once for all eternal covering in Jesus. And we are super blessed to have that.
We are. and so I think it's 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 19 says, you were not redeemed, in other words brought back to God. You were not redeemed with corruptible stuff like silver and gold, but with the precious blood of Jesus. So there is no substitute. There's no way back to God except through the blood of Jesus. There is no other way for you to be redeemed and brought back. And if you are that person today who's just feeling so bad about your sin and your guilt and your shame and your loss that you think life is not worth living, I'm here to tell you that whatever you have done or however far you have gone, the blood of Jesus can go deeper than that. It can go wider than that. And you can be redeemed through his precious blood today. So I just want to, I'm going to ask Hans if he would give thanks for the body of Christ, and then I'll give thanks for the blood. Mm. But as we do this, let it not be just a ritual, you know, where we, this is a church thing to do. This is the thing that they used to do in their homes. This was part of a meal. This was a powerful thing to take bread and wine, recognizing that this represents the most powerful act in the whole of human history. So as we take it today and you think about the bread and the wine, and just as Hans prays, just let the weight of the goodness of God just come on. Thanks.
Thank you, Lord. Well, let's take a piece of bread together. And on the night that Jesus was betrayed, it said he took the bread and he lifted it to heaven and he blessed it. And we know that Jesus is that bread and that he is blessed by the Father. This is my Son with whom I'm well pleased. And Jesus offers himself to us in this bread. And with this bread comes the Father's blessing as well. So we lift you up, Lord, and we bless you, Lord. It says, bless the Lord in the Psalms, and we get the privilege to even just bless you, Lord, for your love for us, Lord, and we lift up this bread and we bless you and we love you and we worship you and we thank you for giving us your body which was broken so that we can have communion and union with you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. So just take the bread and it's interesting that we always had the bread before the wine, and I never understood that until one old gentleman told me, well, the body had to be broken before the blood was shed. So I've satisfied myself with that. But thank you. Thank you, Hans, and thank you, Lord. Took the cup. Huh. The blood of Jesus. I can't get past it today. It's just ringing in my ears. The power of the blood. I think that old song, it reaches to the highest mountain. It goes to the lowest valley. And I've forgotten the rest of it, but it will never lose its power. It loses strength from day to day. So, for us all, but this is for that one person that I'm talking to today. The blood of Jesus poured out for you. And I believe that today, as you just recognize that this is for you, that as you just fall on your knees and say, Lord, be merciful to me, a sinner, Jesus, come into my life, redeem me, cleanse me, make me whole. Again, I need to be saved, or I'm in really deep strife. So if you can just pour out your heart to the Lord, just as his blood was poured out for your sin, he will pour out his love upon you as freely as he gave his blood. So, Father, we thank you for the blood of Jesus. We thank you for this wine. We thank you for what it represents to us. The cleansing, healing, the forgiving power of God through Jesus Christ. And so we just want to say thank you today.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you as we, all over the world, just taking communion with one another and with you.
Yes.
Let's eat and let's drink. You know, this blood actually has such a power in your life. It shifts you. On the inside, it actually shifts you. And it shifts you from guilt to gratitude. It's a big shift. You know, from carrying guilt into a place of gratitude. And it shifts you from shame. Guilt says, I have sinned. Shame says, I am really bad. There's a difference between guilt and shame. Guilt is, yes, I did something bad. Shame says, I am bad. Either way, you're redeemable. So you're going to shift from guilt to gratitude and from shame to shouting praise. You know, shame will keep you locked down and intimidated and embarrassed and with your head always down. But when you get set free from that, you can let out a line, a heck of a shout.
Yeah.
You know? A heck of a shout. and from fear, it'll shift you from fear to favor. Not just fear to faith, which is great, and it does that. But it shifts you from fear before God, thinking, oh, let me cream me if he knew. Well, he does know, and he's not going to cream you because there's a way through. But to get into the favor of God and know that that favor falls upon you is this tremendous joy. So there is a great shift that takes place. And I just want to say to you today, wherever you are, and we have people from different parts of the world now just having communion. It's the same God. It's the same Jesus. It's the same Holy Spirit, the triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, who comes to visit with us whenever we open a door for him. And all over the world, the Spirit of God is moving. And in a sense, we're just having communion with people in New York, and people in Papua New Guinea, and people in Sydney. So it's amazing. So glad that you joined us. I just wonder if Hans has got anything else you'd like to add before we close our little time of communion together.
Just on how Jesus uses his blood as a weapon to just destroy all accusation against you. Roy was sharing about just being transformed from fear to faith, and it says in the book of Revelation that they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony, and loving not their lives unto themselves. And that blood just slashes the accusations of the enemy, because we are fully cleansed and fully clean as we turn our heart towards him. And that blood just cuts off any accusation that that the enemy tries to accuse us before God or to ourselves. And the word of God's testimony to us is that we are clean, redeemed, and set free. So we use those things in communion as a way to just step back into our freedom that God's given us. And it's just, it breaks shame and guilt. So, just allow those words to do that in your life. His grace will come on communion to do that. We remember him in communion and what he did for us to break all those shackles off. So, so good to come every day and remember how free we are in Jesus. It's just, powerful. Thank you so much for giving us an opportunity to do this together.
It's really it's cool. Good, Hans. Thank you. Thank you. We're just going to pray. And you know what? Just to add one last thing, there's healing in the blood. There's healing in the blood. There's forgiveness. There's healing. There's provision. The whole of the new covenant is in this symbol. The presence of the Lord. So if you need healing right now, you can just reach out to the Lord and ask for healing for your body. Just commit it to the Lord. It's not a religious thing. It's not. It's just having a revelation of the power of the blood. And again, for that man, I believe it's a man, that whoever it is that's needing to have a touch from God, stop what you're intending to do. Turn to the Lord. So, Father, we just lift that person up to you and others who are needing healing. And those, Lord, who are longing for a touch of your presence, we just bring these people. Lord, at this time of loneliness or sickness or loss, we bring these people all over the world. The Spirit is moving. And so we just bring to you, Lord, those who are watching at this time, and pray for a revelation of your goodness and your kindness and your mercy and your grace. And Father, I pray that you would bring healing and you would bring peace, so that there'll be nothing missing, nothing broken, but God's peace and grace and love will just flow today. And we give you thanks as we acknowledge again your goodness. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Well, thank you for being with us. It's been just lovely to have you. It's only, 15, 20 minutes max. And it's just a joy to pull aside for a few moments and have this time. So thank you for being with us. God bless you. I pray you have a wonderful week coming up.